Congratulations, we did it. We're here tonight because we can finally say adios to Northcote High School. We've written the essays, we've done the maths questions, and if you're anything like me, you probably handed it in 2 weeks late. We've won football grand finals and debates on national irrigation policy. Through camps and extracurricular activities, we have made friends that, if we don't keep for a lifetime, we will certainly hold in high regard for a lifetime. Tonight, high schooling is over. No, hang on, there seems to be a memo here about exams. Then why are we here graduating tonight? You're probably confused as well. Well, because what we're celebrating is not marked by an exam. Sure, they're important. I mean, right now we have our lives at our fingertips. We're celebrating the people that we have become in the last 6 years. We've changed a lot. But I don't need to point that out. You may feel the same as you were in year 7, but your parents are seeing the change, your friends and your teachers have seen the change. Gosh, when it comes to the pitch of my voice, I think we've all heard the change.
Graduation speeches can become rather vague.
I could say something like, you guys are the best year level ever. And where's the objective evidence for that statement? I mean, you're ignoring Northcote's 88-year history and the 500 other graduating classes in Victoria this year. I'm sure I'm all saying that. But if there are two overarching themes that I think define our year level, they are, one, that we are inclusive. Walking around the school and speaking to you all tonight, I have this warm feeling. Because I know that despite how odd I am, and frankly, how odd you guys are, we are all accepted. Northcote High School is an inclusive school. And that's not always the case. I mean, exploring the archives of people's yearbooks, I discovered an era where students, some of them weren't called by their first name, they were called the fat kid or the Asian. And this is actually in the print of the yearbook. That's not right, and that's no longer the case at Northcote, and I think it's partially thanks to us. We're incredibly diverse at this school, and we celebrate this. Secondly, Northcote High School students stand up for what's right. We've always used our student voice and endeavoured to make the school a better place. It's simple. If something's wrong, we act. An example of this was the Northcote Student Union, which was formed to see that the student representatives were truly representative of students. Northcote High School students are engaged in the affairs of the world. And on the inclusivity point, we're respectful in our views. I mean, it's great to see the socialists and the right-wing conservatives having a fair discussion on the school overall at lunchtime. If we can remember the level of inclusivity and active political voice of our time at Northcote, and continue this into our lives, we will be fair people, we won't be boring people, we will be truly exceptional citizens. The next challenge, maybe, is what we do about deregulation. Is it good for us? Is it good for education? The thing is, we need to speak up. For our lives, we're facing many challenges. VC may be the first. High school is a factor that has shaped our lives. And through our lives, we will shape the world. Thank you, class of 2014.